Man, I think when we do Alice in Chains, it kind of gives you an insight into a certain lifestyle. You know what I'm saying?
People's perception of what you might, how you might have changed, you know, makes them react a certain way when they approach you, you know, before, you know, they've had a chance to see whether or not you've changed. They're just assuming you have, and so they,
right,
you know, might come at you with a different attitude.
What's going on, everybody? We're back with another segment of Rappers React. Smoke Dog.
What up?
If something is filled with muck and just grimy, and it could be just dirty, disgusting, filthy liquid.
Yeah.
What would one call that?
A cesspool. Yeah, nastiness. What about sludge?
You got it, my friend. Guys, before we get started, please do us a big favor. Yo, please hit that thumbs up button. Guys, please subscribe to the channel.
And for God's sake, leave us a comment. Tell us what to react to next, because that's how we get the ideas for these videos. Comes directly from you, right down in the comment section and over on Patreon. And today we have another wonderful suggestion from one of our wonderful Patreon members who goes by the name of Brandon Baugh.
Love the name Brandon Baugh. Don't know why, but it just sounds like a good old manly man.
I'm wondering if it's Baugh or Bo or Bug Baugh.
Spell cough, C-O-U-G-H, right?
Yeah.
So it could, well, that's
C-A, you like caught, bought, caught, B-A, I don't know.
We're analyzing your name.
Brandon, you're a cool dude.
Yeah, shout out to Brandon, because he has been a loyal Patreon member for quite some time, and he has sent us over quite a few suggestions. Brandon Baugh said, look guys, I know I've sent y'all over a bunch of things, but there's one song that I really would like for you guys to check out.
Yeah.
And it's by a band called Alice
in Chains.
Yes, it is.
Man, we've been needing to get back into Alice in Chains because that is iconic.
See, man, what have we done? Junkhead and what else? Is that the only song?
We did Man in the Box.
Man, damn, how's it going?
The man in the box. Yeah.
See, if y'all knew street or hood terminology, you get where I'm going? You could be the man in the box.
Yeah.
You get where I'm going?
Yeah, that makes you the man.
In the box.
In the box.
All right.
Yeah.
But yeah, Brandon said, look, guys, you got to check out this song called Sludge Factory.
Sludge Factory.
If I had to ask you what you think this song is about, break it down, Schmoke.
Man, see, I want to go to what Layne Staley went through in his life, you know, thinking about that. And, you know, the guy was extremely depressed. And he was caught up in the drug life, you know. And, man, I saw this piece on him where I forgot who it was. But someone was talking about the last days of his life. And he had lost, like, he was under 100 pounds.
Oh, man.
Because he was so hooked on the drugs, you know. And
how tall do you think he was?
I don't know. I would guess 5'9", 5'10". I don't know. But they said he was under 100 pounds, like extremely emaciated when he died.
Mm-hmm.
And he was just going through this horrible funk, you know, like he just couldn't snap out of it. And he kept doing the drugs. He couldn't stop. Like he was wanting to and couldn't, you know, and he said, like, I'm not even doing it because I like it anymore. I'm doing it just because I can't stop.
Damn, dude.
It's crazy. So Sludge Factory, maybe talking about the place that drugs are made,
Sludge Factory.
Maybe.
I'm thinking more of the lines of something like, you know, being a part of a system or being a part of a country or government that just produces filth, that just produces, you know, sludge. If you will.
Some people would call things like the porn industry maybe a sludge factory.
But you agree with that though? Do you think that industry could be a sludge factory?
The porn industry?
Yeah. I mean, keep it real.
Well, I mean, it all depends on... I mean, it's subjective. It all depends on how you view that industry. You know what I'm saying?
See, I don't know. If you're doing things the right way, if you're not hurting anybody.
Yeah.
I mean.
Oh, I agree. I mean, if you're making a living and, you know, and it's not hurting anyone else, then that's your liberty to do that.
Because someone could say in the same breath that you could look at the pharmaceutical companies as a sludge factory.
Yeah. Like the place where drugs are made. Thank you. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
Yeah.
Shmoda!
What up?
Let's get into it.
Let's do it.
Right in your face. It's a three-legged dog.
Yeah.
Right? Mm. This is him singing?
Yeah.
He's got a very distinct voice.
Oh, he does. The real way. There's no pressures besides brilliance. Let's say by day night. In this corporate ignorance, let's be control time.
Serious. chill.
Man, I think when we do Alice in Chains, it kind of gives you an insight into a certain lifestyle. You know what I'm saying?
What do you mean?
Like that lifestyle that he was living, like I talked about earlier. You know, that he was deep in that drug lifestyle, you know?
Yeah.
And he couldn't get out. And I almost feel like maybe this song was him talking about someone talking to him. About the lifestyle he was living.
Say you know, that he again? Someone talking.
He's talking. It seems like, I don't know for sure, but it seems like he's talking about someone who is talking about him.
Oh.
About the lifestyle he's living. You know, okay. He kept saying your weapon is guilt, obviously, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, the discolored skin and right. Whatever. And, yeah, I think he accepted his fate at some point.
You think so?
I think so. I think he just knew. Like, I'm just going to end up doing this until it means my demise, you know?
And you said earlier that he basically admitted that he just kept doing it because he can't physically stop.
Yeah, that's apparently what he was saying.
Damn. Sorry for that, guys.
Don't silence the phone or anything.
My bad.
But, yeah, he basically was, yeah, he just accepted it at some point. Like, guys, I can't stop. This is what I do.
Damn.
I'm just going to do it until it's all over.
You sound like you might be right there on it, man. With his Lane Staley, right?
Yes.
This guy, his lyrics, man. The part where he was like, let me bring this up real quick because mm-hmm. I don't want to misquote this because this one line that stuck. He's a part of the 27 Club, isn't he?
You know what? I have to look up. Maybe he was around that age.
Google that for me, real quick.
Yeah, I will. Go ahead and read. But,
if he was a part of that club, which Smoke Dog's Googling it right now, I'm just curious. You should have just.
Yeah. All right. From 67 to 02.
What's that? 67 to 02.
Oh, yeah, that's old. That's. No, he was a little older.
He was older than that. Okay, the reason I said that is because one part, he said. Dude, and like you were saying about when he was like, you know, basically talking about his use of drugs,
mm-hmm.
If he is talking from the perspective of someone else that's talking about him, I don't know if I said that right, but he said, now the body of one soul I adore wants to die. You have always told me you'd not live past 25.
Mm-hmm.
That, the fact that, someone could potentially see now reading that it almost sounds like he's talking about a friend, you mm-hmm. know, a body, somebody that he truly loved, that he truly adored, you know, I really like this person, but this same person that I liked has always said, hey, I'm probably not going to be here past 25 because of the substances that I've been using.
Mm-hmm. But just knowing the way he went out, you know, makes me think that he might have been talking about someone talking to him, right. You know what I'm saying? But, I mean, it could very well be.
What is that called? Isn't there a word for that? When someone...
What do you mean?
Like, when someone's talking about... When you hear someone saying something... I don't know. I'm thinking... What I'm thinking is, like, you know, when they say, oh, you're talking in third person.
Uh-huh.
I guess you could say, hey, that you're talking in fifth person or something. I don't know.
Yeah, it could be.
I don't know.
Like, I'm talking as someone that's talking to someone about me.
Correct.
Fifth person.
There you go. Man, Lane Staley, dude, he was a... And this is something I really wasn't put up on. This guy is... a deep lyricist.
Oh, he is, yeah.
Deep.
Dude, and I can see why they threw blues into that track, too, because of the subject there, right. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And you were talking about the picture, the dog.
Break that down.
Dude, I think that's a summation of the whole mood. I mean, I guess that was the album cover. But I think that perfectly displayed an artistic form of what was actually going on. I mean, look at that dog. He's missing an arm. He's going through a rough life. He's been through a rough life. The dog looks sad. That dog looks old, worn out, and just done with life at that point. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I think that displays how Lane was feeling at the time.
So you're basically saying that picture was a perfect representation of mm-hmm. what he was going through.
Yes.
Huh.
You like might. I'm just beat up and, you know,
man,
I'm done at this point, you know. And I don't know how far along in his life this album came out, but, man, it's tough, man. It's tough to know what that dude went through.
Not only that, but me and you have a different, you know, perspective on it. You know, I have been through addiction.
Mm-hmm.
And people say, you know, you don't wish jail or death on anybody. I've always said you don't wish jail, death, addiction, or unemployment. Because those are things that you... Addiction is a real disease, man.
Yeah. All of those can kill you.
Dude, you're right.
Yeah.
Jail can kill you. Uh-huh. Death, you're dead. Yeah. Addiction can kill you. And unemployment can...
Kill you.
Wow.
In the right circumstances. Yeah.
Brandon, listen.
Yeah.
Great song choice. I think me and you gonna have to go a little deeper into Alice in Chains.
Oh, bro. We do, man. And you know, at first we were just on like, wow, this is a unique blend of the grunge that was out at the time, and you know, a little bit of that groove metal, you know. But dude, it's there deeper. Is so much more to Alice in Chains. Yeah.
Yeah. Real quick, a question for the Trash Talkers: if they have given out an explanation as to what exactly Alice in Chains means, I think I have a. Somewhat of an idea, mm-hmm. but if I would like to know if they actually said.
Yeah, I would like to know that too.
Man. With that being said, guys, my name's Behringer Hollywood 6. Bye.
I am Larry Smokey Ramirez Cowan.
And we are
over
and
out.
Deuces.
I want to thank you guys for tuning in to Rappers React today. If you want to see another artist that we covered, it's right over here. If you want to see the last video we did, it's right over here. Thank you guys for tuning in. We do this for you. Please go ahead and hit that subscribe button if you will. Give us a thumbs up, and we'll see you on the next one. Deuces.